everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we are doing an ever-changing landscape. As your plants mature, bushes get big, they get old, sometimes they need to be taken out. And that's what's happening along the back here. We are going to be leaving the Alberta spruce, but taking out these junipers that are here. And then over near the house, we're going to be leaving that one Alberta spruce on the corner, but all the rest of those yews are leaving. And then this, I think this is a arborvitae cedar kind of thing. We're going to be sorting out those branches and either doing a more of a topiary or just clearing out a little bit more so that the pond isn't shaded all the time. Looking around the yard as we are walking around and thinking about our bushes, you never realize that 2 weeks ago, parts of Wisconsin had 33 inches of snow.
38.
Well, that too. We fortunately didn't get that much. We had maybe 8 inches or so, but it started out as rain, and then there was ice, and then the sleet, and then really heavy snow on top. So it was a mess. And there were piles of snow everywhere for the longest time, and now it's gone. And this coming week, it's going to be in the 70s. So things are starting to pop, and we want to get these things done before it gets too hot to work out here.
Well, we've already taken a trailer load full.
We have, yes. And that was just like one bush.
Well, we tried to do a video in the snow.
Yes.
And I was wearing gloves, and it muffed out the sound completely. So we couldn't even use that footage.
Right. So we're starting all over again. An ever-changing landscape. Well, here are the tools that we're going to be using today. We have a variety of loppers. This is the one from the Dram Corporation that is very sharp. This is one that has stood by us for 30 years. And this is our ratcheting one that is so very helpful if you're doing larger stems. And then we have saws. We have hand saws, and then we have this saw. Now, if we were doing trimming on a tree or a bush that we were going to keep, we would be sure to clean off the blades with an alcohol wipe. But since we are taking out bushes that we're getting rid of, taking to the recycling center, we don't need to worry about that right now.
Why is that important to sterilize your tools?
Well, because you don't want to transfer any germs or insect larvae or whatever from one living tree or something you're taking out and then introducing it to a healthy bush that you want to keep.
So it's possible that an old bush could be diseased.
Right.
You don't know what it has necessarily, and you just don't want to transfer it to something
exactly
that you do want to keep.
That goes with flowers or roses or whatever you're trimming. If it's a live plant that you're keeping, you want to make sure you're not transferring diseases from one to another.
Well, you also want sharp tools. Tools that are effective.
Those are good. About a week and a half ago, while there was still snow on the ground, we started by taking out this bush. And we just used the lopper on this one. Our chainsaws, unfortunately, are being repaired and tuned up and won't be ready until next weekend. But we can do a lot of trimming before that and then come back and take care of these stumpy parts.
Well, it'll be a lot easier to get rid of the small brush first and get that in the trailer and out to the recycling center.
Exactly.
And then come back and get the main trunks.
And if they're too hard to get out, then we have resources for that also.
Take two.
This has been a quick change. Look at this. Look at how much better this looks. It's amazing already.
Oh, goody. More room for more flowers.
Yes. Remember how they looked over here? This is how they look now. But eventually they will be chopped up and other people will use them. So that's good. Look out, here I come. Next garden we're in. The nice thing about these is that they're arborvitae and they're not pokey like those junipers were. This one is way overgrown and we have to keep it away from the air conditioner all the time, so it's time for them to go. Voila! What a difference this is on area two. You can even see that we have plants in here that have been trying to grow. Amazing.
So what are you going to put in here?
I haven't decided yet.
Okay. And you are going to keep that Alberta, huh?
I think so. I may trim it back a little bit.
Make a topiary?
Area three, boxwoods. These boxwoods have been here for years and years and years. They've gone through some bad winters and some good winters. This actually was a pretty good winter so far. We're going to take these out and create an entrance, a welcoming entrance to the gardens. So these have to go. Unfortunately, we're using my Jeep to do the pulling. I hope Bluebell's up to it.
I'm sure she is. Well, let me go in and do my little magic.
Here we go. Okay, so this is the last bunch. Get this one out. That's good. Here we go. Well, that was exciting, but now we have a nice, clear, open area where we can actually have a nice entrance into the yard. Something that's more inviting and doesn't look like it's overgrown or in need of some work, right? So, another project, another day. It was fun, though.
Well, we only made three trips to the recycling center.
Yes, so far. Thank goodness we have a place.
And we went through three ropes.
Yeah, we did.
So, that was an expensive project.
Indeed. But it'll look really nice when we get done. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have comments or questions, we'd love to hear them. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe right over here. Thank you for watching.
Can I take a shower now?
I wish you would.
Thank you.
Connect with us on YouTube.